Welcome back, everybody. Some people love perfume, others love jewelry. Well, Kym has the perfect DIY that combines both. Boom, just
That's
like that. Right,
Kym? Drop the mic, absolutely.
Drop the
you
mic.
You know what, Cameron? I was actually very inspired by the Hallmark Channel's new movie, The Last Bridesmaid. It stars Rachel Boston. She plays Becca, and Paul Campbell plays Kyle. You worked with Paul, right?
I did. Yes. I love them both. They're both fantastic.
Yeah, and Becca is always a bridesmaid. Don't I know it? You're preaching to the choir. So, you know, she goes to her cousin's wedding, and she bonds with Kyle. He's a videographer. And one thing leads to another. I'm not going to spoil the movie for you.
No, please don't.
Don't. You have to watch it. And speaking of bridesmaids, you know, it's always great to give them a gift. So I thought, why not create a DIY perfume? Because, you know, I am not into chemicals, and I like to have things that are personalized. And recently, actually, before my health journey, I was putting on some perfume, and I started sneezing constantly.
Oh, no.
I was like, nope, not going to do this anymore. I'm going to do my own.
Amazing. And not just any kind of perfume. We're going to do a solid version and a roll-on version.
We are.
And we're going to start with a solid perfume, which is a little bit, seems like an oxymoron almost.
I know.
It seems like it's not quite right, but you'll explain this.
You're going to be able to wear it. And Cameron, this could be such a beautiful gift for the lovely Vanessa. Here is a locket. I just decided, you know what, why not have a little locket? I have some from my grandmother in Scotland. And this, we just put a little bit of the solid perfume in there. And then all you do is throughout the day, you can just rub this very gently, or you can even put it in a container like this, and then even put like a little sticker on
it. And do you just put it like on your wrist?
Yeah, it's in a solid, so you just put it on, you know, you want to put it on the pulse point, so you just put it on there, and then you can just replenish it all day as you feel it kind of dissipating.
Beautiful.
Isn't that nice?
It looks so great.
And it's so easy.
It's so, well, we're going to find out.
Yeah,
let me show you.
Okay, all you have to do is get a double boiler, and then you just want to add some of the beeswax, and this is to make it solid.
Okay.
So I'm just going to pour a little bit of this into our double boiler.
So this is what will make the perfume become solid once it cools again.
Exactly.
Okay, very good.
And then you want to add the sweet almond oil, and that is because it is very moisturizing and hydrating. And here's a secret, Cameron, whether you're using this or not. Do you know that scent does not attach to dry skin very well? It likes to attach to anything that has moisture on it. I've even heard of girls that have put Vaseline on their pulse points before they add a scent because it's going to hold on, it's going to attach.
That fascinating.
Yeah.
You become like a chemistry teacher.
Literally.
You've got your science lab here.
I need it.
You're giving us great tips. It's amazing.
I love beauty
Okay,
labs.
So you mix these together.
Yes. So what you're going to do, we don't want to waste the time, but you mix it all the way down so that it becomes a liquid.
Okay.
And then you're going to see that this very quickly, I did this just a second ago, turns into a solid very, very quickly. But before it does, we want to add our scents. And the first scent, which is our base scent, would be sandalwood. And I'm going to put, I want you to just take a little sniff of that.
Sandalwood
it's kind of masculine.
Is one of my favorite things
is
in
it?
The world.
It is.
It actually really is, truthfully.
And you want to do like about 15 drops of this, you guys. Then you want to add your middle note, which is going to be rosemary. And you just add about 10 drops of that. Again, it's all according to how strong you like your scent. I like it a little bit lighter. And then last, you're going to put your top note on, and that is cinnamon. And cinnamon is really, I mean, I don't need to have you smell that, but
no, but I'll smell it anyway.
Yeah, it's just so nice. Isn't it just
it's,
have that?
It's also one of my favorite things. This could also almost be like a holiday perfume, too,
right,
on some level.
There's
something sort of festive about this.
So before this, you know, I'm so afraid that it's going to harden. Oh, there we go. So I'm going to have you, we're going to do it and show you, how you make your very own. Yep, so what you want to do is you want to take it, and you can either use this, the little dropper, or you can do this, and I'm
pour
just going to pour it.
Yep. And if it starts to solidify a little bit, I bet you could also just kind of scoop it and then and mold it into place as well.
Am I burning your fingers?
No, you're not. I'm very tough, Kym.
You are. You are a tough cookie. Look at how beautiful that is. And then you know what we do? We just take like a little knife and we'll just kind of clear that out. Once it's solid, it hardens and gets even more solid. And then you just close up your little locket and you wear it around your neck all day.
I think it's a really beautiful idea.
Isn't this great?
Yeah, it's such a great idea, especially for perfume, which I wouldn't have thought of. And so is this. I mean, obviously you're used to things like antiperspirant deodorant, which was the last time we did a DIY together, being a roll-on, but not a roll-on perfume, or at least I'm not used to it.
No, that isn't, you know, and also when you do find these roll-on perfumes, they're very expensive in the stores, Cameron. I could not believe how easy it is to make your very own, ladies and gentlemen. So these are perfect. I pop these in my purse. They're great for on the go.
How cool
they're
is
great
that?
To carry along with you if you go camping, you and Vanessa, and the great silver streams that you go in. I love that.
Wow.
So you want to do a carrier oil first. And I found in my research that grapeseed oil is really great, Cameron, because you want to fill, if you do a jar about this big, you want to go about that far up, about a quarter. And what I found is grapeseed oil is a great carrier oil because it has no scent.
So it's
going to allow the scents that we're going to make, and it's also very hydrating.
Gotcha. Okay,
then
that's a good point.
We're going to start with our base notes, and this is a wonderful one. This is rose, and who doesn't love rose, right? So you want to do about 7 of these, and I just put it in the dropper because I know. I mean, I just do it right from the jar because I know already.
Okay.
And then jasmine is another scent that I love. And this is kind of, again, the middle. And you want to do about 7 of those too, or again, according to your nose palette. And then chamomile. I have a cup of chamomile tea every night after dinner. Cameron, it's just
very soothing.
It's so soothing. It's so calming. And you know what else about essential oils? Yeah. Essential oils also kind of help with just any frazzled nerves that you have. You're a little bit nervous about something. Yeah. It's so nice because it just calms and soothes. And then your top note is going to be the lemon. And we just add this at the very top.
So as you do that and you kind of bring it together and get it into the bottle,
you put it in
will
there.
Become the roller. I want to ask you, how do you go about choosing the different scents that you put in?
That's a
Can
great
I help
question.
You with this?
Yeah, well, you know what? We already did it. So all you have to do is you just take it, ladies, and then you just put it, you know, in there, and then it turns into your roller.
It turns into this one, and you put the little rolling device on top.
And then you can even add a little bit of your rose petals.
But where do I put it? Here?
Oh, your pulse points.
Okay.
And Cameron, what I wanted to say is on our website and also here, we're going to just describe to you about the base notes and then the middle notes. There they are. And the top notes. And how I could tie this into you, you know when you make your smoothie, you put your base, which is like your banana, that's
there
your
you
base
go.
Note. Your middle notes would be the other things you add in, like your fruits, right? And then your top note would maybe be like the little extras,
my little MCT oil I put in there or something like that.
And
so
that
good.
Is according to whatever your palate.
This smells so nice. And are those little flowers?
Those are
the
little, we just got some little dried rose petals.
That's beautiful.
And I just sprinkled them
in.
Cameron, always smell like a rose to me.
Well, I do when I finish doing a DIY with you. I feel like every time I do, I smell better and better. Thank you, Kim, for more information. Go to HallmarkChannel.com.